13th October 2020 morning Murli Om Shanti Bab Dada Madhuban Sweet children you receive one direction from the one father it is called the undivided direction it is by following this undivided direction that you become deities question what main thing have human beings forgotten in this game of the maze answer Having gone into the game of the maze, they have forgotten their way home. They don't know when or how they can return home. The father has now come to take all of you back with him. Your effort now is to go beyond sound to the sweet home. Song. Oh, traveler of the night. Do not become weary. Your days of happiness are about to come. Om Shanti. According to the drama plan, no one else can understand the meaning of the song. There are some songs composed by people outside that can help you. You children understand that you are now becoming deities. Just as those who study worldly studies say that they are becoming doctors or barristers. So, it is in your intellects that you are becoming deities from the new world. Only you have these thoughts. The new world, the golden age is called the land of immortality. At present, there is no golden age or kingdom of deities that cannot exist here. You know that you have been around the cycle and reached the end of the Iron Age. The cycle does not enter the intellects of anyone else. They say that the duration of the Golden Age is hundreds of thousands of years. You children have the faith that the cycle really does turn every 5000 years. Human beings only take 84 births. There is an account. This deity religion is called the undivided religion. There is also the undivided scripture. There is only one of those. Otherwise, there are innumerable religions and innumerable scriptures elsewhere. You are only one. You receive one direction from the one. This is called the undivided direction. It is you who receive the undivided direction. The study is to become deities. This is why the father is called the ocean of knowledge and knowledgeful. You children understand that God is teaching you for the new world. Do not forget this. Would students in a school forget their teacher? No. Those living at home with their families study in order to attain a better position. You are also studying while living at home with your families in order to progress. It should enter your hearts that you are studying with the unlimited father. Shubaba is Baba and Prajapita Brahma is Baba. The name Prajapita Brahma, Adi Dev, is very well known. It is just that he existed in the past, just as Gandhiji also existed in the past. They called him Bapuji, means father, but they don't think he was that. They just say it. Shiv Baba really is that. Brahma Baba is also that, and a physical father is really that. However, they call the mayor of a city father only for the sake of it. All of those are artificial, whereas this one is real. The Father, the Supreme Soul, comes and makes souls belong to him through Prajapita Brahma. He must definitely have many children. All are the children of Shiv Baba. Everyone remembers him. Nevertheless, some don't even accept him. They are firm atheists who say that this world is created with a thought. The father now explains to you, keep it in your intellects that you are studying and that it is Shiv Baba who is teaching you. Remember this day and night. It is this that Maya makes you forget again and again. This is why you have to remember Baba. You forget all three, the father, the teacher and the Sadguru. He is only one, but you still forget him. It is in this that you battle with Ravan. The father says, "Oh souls, you were Satupradhan and have now become Tamapradhan. You were pure when you were in the land of peace. No souls can stay above without purity. This is why all souls call out to the purifier father. When everyone has become impure and Tamapradhan, the father comes and says, I make you Satapradhan. When you were all in the land of peace, you were pure. No impure souls can stay there. Everyone definitely has to experience punishment and become pure. No one can return home without becoming pure. Although they say that so and so has merged into the Brahma element, or that so and so has merged into the element of light. All of those are the innumerable ideas of the path of devotion. This is your undivided direction. Only the one father can change you from humans into deities. Every cycle, the father comes to teach you. His act continues exactly as it did in the previous cycle. This drama is eternally predestined. The world cycle continues to turn. There is the golden age, the silver age, the copper age, the iron age, and then there is this confluence age. The main religions are Judaism, Islamism, Buddhism and Christianity. They are those who have a kingdom. There is no kingdom of the Brahmins or of the Kauravas. You children now have to remember the unlimited father again and again. You can also explain to worldly Brahmins. Baba has told you many times, first there is the Brahmin top knot. You are first the progeny of Brahma. You know that latter on the path of devotion, you are the ones who become worshippers from being worthy of worship. You are now becoming worthy of worship. Those worldly Brahmins are householders and not sannyasis. Sannyasis are hatha yogis. They force themselves to learn their households. Hatha yogis teach many types of yoga. There is a museum of hatha yogis in Jaipur, but there are no images of Raj Yoga there. It is only in the Delwara temple that there are images of Raj Yoga. There is no museum of that. There are so many museums of hatha yoga. It is only in Bharat that they have temples of Raj Yoga. This museum is in the living form. You are sitting here in the living form. People don't know where heaven is. In the Dilwara temple, you are shown seated on the ground doing tapasya. That is a complete memorial of you. Heaven is portrayed above you. People do believe that heaven is up above. This cycle continues to turn. After half the cycle, heaven will go down below. And then at the end of the cycle, heaven will come up above. No one knows how long its duration is. The father has explained the whole cycle to you. When the cycle comes to an end, you take the knowledge and go up above, and then the cycle starts afresh. You should turn this around in your intellects. When those people study knowledge, they have their books, etc. in their intellects. Do they not? This too is a study. Keep yourself filled with this. Do not forget it. All, old, young and children have a right to study this study. You simply have to know Alpha. Once you know Alpha, the father's property will enter your intellect. Even animals keep their children in their intellects. When they go into a forest, they still continue to remember their home and their young ones. They automatically find their young ones. The father now says, children, constantly remember me alone and also remember your home, from where you came to play your parts. Souls love their home. They remember their home so much, but they have forgotten their way back. It is in your intellects that you live very far away. However, no one knows how you can go there or why you are unable to go there. Baba has explained that this is why the game of the maze has been created. Whichever way you go, the door is closed. You know that the gates to heaven will open after this war. Everyone will leave this land of death. All human beings will go and stay there, number wise, according to their religions and according to their parts. All of these things are in your intellects. People beat their heads so much in order to go to the Brahma element. You have to go beyond sound. No sound remains when a soul leaves his body. You children know that that is your sweet home. There is then the sweet kingdom, the undivided kingdom of the deities. The father comes and teaches you Raj Yoga. He explains to you the full knowledge from which the scriptures are later created on the path of devotion. You don't need to study those scriptures etc. now. Old mothers don't study in those schools. Here everyone studies. Your children become deities in the land of immortality. There no such words of defamation are spoken. You now know that heaven existed in the past. There is praise of heaven. They built so many temples. Ask them, when did Lakshmi and Narayan exist in the past? They don't know anything at all. You now know that you have to return home. It has been explained to you children that the meaning of Om is different from the meaning of Hum So. They have made the meaning of Om and the meaning of Hum So the same. You souls are residents of the land of peace. You come down here to play your parts. You become deities, warriors, merchants and shudras. Om means I am a soul. There is so much difference. They have taken the meaning of both to be the same. These matters have to be understood with your intellects. Those who don't understand fully continue to nod off all the time. You never nod off when you are earning an income. That income is for a temporary period. This income is for half the cycle. However, when your intellect wanders off in other directions, you become tired and continue to yawn. You must not sit here with your eyes closed. You know that souls are imperishable and that bodies are perishable. There is the difference of day and night between the way Iron Age residents of hell look at everything and the way you look at everything. I, a soul, am studying with the Father. No one knows that the Supreme Father, the Supreme Soul, the ocean of knowledge comes to teach us. I, a soul, am listening to Him. It is only by considering yourselves to be souls and remembering the Father that your sins will be absolved. Your intellects will go up above. Shiva Bhai is speaking this knowledge to us. A very refined intellect is required for this. Baba shows you the way to refine your intellects. By considering yourselves to be souls, you will definitely remember the Father. The reason why you have to consider yourselves to be souls is so that you can remember the Father and form that relationship which has been broken for the whole cycle. that there is just the reward of happiness and only happiness. There is no question of sorrow there. That is called heaven. Only heavenly God the Father makes you into the masters of heaven. You even forget such a father. The father comes and adopts you children. Many children are adopted by the Marwari caste. They become very happy because they have gone into the laps of wealthy ones. Children of the wealthy would never be adopted by the poor. You are children of Prajapita Brahma, therefore you would definitely be mouth bone creations. You Brahmins are mouth bone creations. Those creations are born through poison. You understand the difference in this. Only when you explain to them can they become mouth bone creations. This is an adoption. A husband considers his wife to belong to him. Is the wife created through poison or through the mouth? The wife is a mouth bone creation. Then when they have children, those creations are born through poison. The father says, all of you are mouth bone creations. When it is said, you are mine, you belong to me, do you not? When it is said, these are my children, the intoxication rises. Therefore, all of you are mouth bone creations. Souls are not mouth bone creations. Souls are eternal and imperishable. You know how the human world is transferred. You children have received many points. Nevertheless, Baba says, even if you are unable to imbibe anything or speak about anything, simply remember the father and you will be able to claim a status higher than those who give lectures. Sometimes even those who give lectures fall due to storms. However, if they didn't fall and simply continue to remember the father, they could claim a high status. Those who indulge in vices, they must break all their bones because that is like falling from the fifth floor. Body consciousness is the fifth floor, lust is the fourth floor, and so on. The father says lust is the greatest enemy. Some children write, Baba, I have fallen. For anger, it isn't said that they have fallen. When someone dirties his face, he hurts himself badly. He is unable to tell others that lust is the greatest enemy. Baba repeatedly says, be very cautious about criminal eyes. In the golden age, there is no question of being stripped. There are no criminal eyes. The eyes become civil. That is a civilian, means civilized kingdom. At this time, the word is criminal. You souls have now received civil eyes, which continue to work for 21 births. No one becomes criminal there. The father explains the main thing. Remember the father and the cycle of 84 births. It is a wonder how the one who becomes Sri Narayan then becomes the lucky chariot at the end. The father enters him, therefore he becomes very lucky. Let the history of 84 births, of how Brahma becomes Vishnu and how Vishnu becomes Brahma, remain in your intellects. Achha. To the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada, the spiritual father says namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, refine your intellect with remembrance of the father. Always keep your intellect full of this knowledge. Constantly remember the father and the home, and also remind others to do this. Second point, finish your criminal eyes in this last birth. and make them civil. Be very cautious about your criminal eyes. Blessing, may you become a solvent who experiences the ascending stage by keeping a balance of remembrance and service. Explanation: when you have a balance of remembrance and service, you will continue to experience the ascending stage at every step. When you have service in every thought, you will be liberated from waste. Make service part of your life, just as all organs are necessary for the body. In the same way, service is a special organ for Brahmin life. To have many chances to do service, to have a place to do service and company to do it with, are also signs of fortune. Those who take such a golden chances to do service become sovereigns. Slogan: the form of God's sustenance of love is an easy yogi life. Om Shanti.